IVM.
Hey, everybody, welcome to another week on the IVM Podcast Network. As I mentioned last week, we're going through this COVID-19 outbreak, and because of that, recording schedules, we're trying to keep them, but it's a little uneven at this point in time. Beg your indulgence. While you are stuck at home, I think one thing that might be interesting to do is maybe check out some of the complete series that we've done. The Gulaba Cartel, Woody Woodpecker, Kriyawala Chronicles. These are limited series that are complete. Might be a good time to check out with those. Also want to thank our sponsors this week, HDFC Life and Paytm Money. And with that, let me get you onto your show and stay safe, everyone.
The language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative. All right, before we start this, Cyrus says, I think it's called, and introduce our lovely guests. I have to quickly mention, I can't take the insurance ads around anymore. The hoardings are everywhere. There are 10,000 people telling you must die so your family can live. I can't bear it. It's morbid and macabre. Can you please stop with the insurance ads? Every time I pass, I feel guilty. I'm still alive. And my kids are starving. Stop it. It's called Cyrus Says.
Do you wish you were smarter? Well, so do we. But the next best thing?
We could make you sound smarter.
And to help you with this endeavor, we are Simplified, a podcast that attempts to break down the complex world around you with a little knowledge, a lot of poor jokes, and a ton of random trivia.
Episodes out every Monday
on the IVM Podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts.
See ya!
Freishia, welcome to this show. This show is all about, well, we don't have anything. I can't offer you anything.
That's true.
We don't have a head, thorax or abdomen like insects. We have nowhere to go, no process. But we have your bio.
Which is so great. I mean, you had a printout. I'm so impressed.
A printout, but the font is too small, so I have no idea what it says.
Right.
So could you just help us through it a little bit?
You're going to make me read my own bio.
Yeah, just a little bit. But I'll tell you one thing I did read, or was read out to me. Mm-hmm. You have worked with, now I have to hold it closer. Mm. You have worked with Shahrukh Khan, Hrithik Roshan, Sachin Tendulkar, Saif Ali Khan, Salman Khan, Ajay Devgan, Priyanka Chopra, Shilpa Shetty. My name is not there.
That is true. Yeah. And I have worked with you.
So I'm taking a pen.
Yeah.
And I'm adding it here.
Yep.
And above all.
Cyrus.
And above all, Cyrus. Okay. Because we did a whole...
But you need to write Cyrus Brocha because I've also worked with Sahu.
Oh, right. And not Saukar. We'll just specify.
Specify.
Yeah, so that he doesn't get any mention. That damn animal. But... we did Khatron Ke Khiladi, which is, what is it in English?
Fear Factor.
Fear Factor. In 2010.
We did.
When I was a young warthog.
I was a child.
God, should have been arrested for that one. But South American laws are different. Yeah.
And that was so much fun, Sai.
It was actually.
So, did
Except
you...
Except Carl, your boyfriend, then came late to fetch you from the airport when we came back. That I remember. Because
oh, yeah?
My wife and two young kids were waiting in prime position. And I said, Freishia, do you need a lift? And you were screaming on the phone at him.
And telling him, why are you not here?
Because he couldn't get parking or something. And Aisha was telling me, should we drop her? And I said, no, let's go. It's been 22 hours.
Also, I mean, it was an unexpected departure for both of us. We came back to Bombay much earlier than we thought.
You shouldn't tell them we did setting and left early and all that.
I don't know if we want to say that.
Why spoil a good thing? But it was a fun 3 weeks at least in Rio.
It was.
Yeah.
It was. And I mean, I actually did overcome a couple of fears, you know that?
Fear of? Indian men?
There were quite a few of them
God,
on that
everywhere.
Show.
Everywhere, my God. Imagine you go all the way to beautiful, sunny Rio and all you hear is Hindi in the background.
Yeah.
Kya? Kahan se? Kahan se?
Kya ho raha hai?
Oh, God. Because we are speaking Hindi. even the locals spoke it better.
The two Parsis spoke the Hindi.
The two
Parsis spoke Hindi as badly as the locals.
We did, no?
Yeah.
But did we speak in the show? Because I can't remember now.
I don't think so. We just had to make lots of expressions and we had to just do things that were pretty scary.
And look like you have a lot of anxiety.
I actually did.
On which ones? I can't even remember them.
So there was this one thing that we had to do where I had to go into a tank where I was chained.
Yes.
And you had to take the keys.
Right.
And every time you unlocked it, the tank would come up a little more.
The water.
And
huh?
if you, yeah.
And that so she was could have drowned. If you're listening to this right now, Freishia could have drowned and I sort of saved her or didn't.
You didn't.
Find out.
Because that's when I had to overcome my fear of being in water.
But I have very poor motor skills here. I just can't, open locks. I have my own house key. you know, I'm always, how can you get the same thing wrong all the time? It's like a, can I use the word retarded, or is that wrong to use?
No, it's mentally challenged.
It's mentally challenged, aka retarded. So let's not use retarded. But yeah, so do you do that?
I have such a problem with the house keys. And everyone at home keeps looking at me. First of all, I have this.
Right or left? It's just 50%.
First of all, I'm one of those Gujju Ben aunties where I have this whole gucha of 10 keys, right?
Because it's not Gujju Ben. This is very Indian. I've seen it in too many people.
Huh, but somehow, why does the man never have the gucha?
I don't even have a key.
You know, and then they wonder, why are purses so heavy? What's in your bag? How many things are you carrying?
Can I tell you my problem? I suggested to my mom, sorry, I'll let you finish that story first. Finish that story.
About the fear?
No, about the
opening. Oh, about the keys. Huh. And yeah, that's it. So by the time, you know, I need to open this door, everyone's just standing there. They've probably had a cup of tea, finished that outside.
And they can hear the problem area of the click-clock happening as much as your Freshia's back.
And sitting in the hall right by the door, but still not opening it.
Of course not.
Yeah, just
so it's fun for them to enjoy the whole, after 20 years, she doesn't know left from right, right from left, but it's the same thing with me, man.
And
just,
while my dog is scratching the door.
Oh, same thing. And absolutely. Going like, barking and crying. Yeah, the moron is back.
She's
open
here,
the door.
She's
he
here.
Can't understand. There's two different dogs, two different scripts, but same story. Yeah.
But dogs are like that.
Dogs are the only thing worth living for.
I totally
some people
agree.
Like plants, but what the hell? You throw a ball, the plant doesn't move. I'm like, come on.
Yeah.
Even a dead dog does better than that.
Or a cat.
Cats may go. Cats are moody.
Moody?
Yeah,
I've,
because
I've
they
never
sometimes
been a cat
they don't
person.
Bring the ball back to you because it's never about you. Hmm. But they may get the ball and play with it or tear it, or you know, it's like that.
Right.
You don't like
right.
cats?
I'm not a cat person.
Oh,
no.
But how
no.
can you be a selective animal lover? That I find hard to believe.
Oh.
Do you? You only like dogs?
Yeah, I only like dogs.
I like all animals.
No.
I even like some politicians.
They're pretty much the same, aren't they?
It's evolution gone the other way, but why get into that? Freishia, this show's about you.
Yes.
If we talk about you, not about locks.
True.
And dogs and cats and, you know, throwing balls. I mean, come on. It's not an infant show.
True.
It will be soon, though. We'll probably get a diaper to sponsor it. Do you know a brand? Do you have kids?
No, I don't.
So what's going on there? Girl shooting blanks?
Well, we're pretty much not going to have
kids.
Oh,
you're not going to?
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
We're one of
after
those
hearing
couples.
Donald Trump's speech yesterday, I'm saying, why kids? There's no point.
Or when he got introduced as Donald.
No, Doland. Just leave it there.
Yeah,
because I have it.
Say.
I heard it 8 times. I sent it to all my friends. We've gone through it. I don't want to, you know, I don't want to go threadbare over it. But the word used, Doland.
I know. I'm just too much of a woman to say it.
Look, listen, don't you remember when we were younger and you said that Donald Duck and all? Nobody can say that name correctly. Because when you were cricket crazy and Donald Bradman was the greatest of all time, no one can say the name Donald. Hey, Donald. And now, Shri, not to mention names, Doland.
Has shown us exactly how it is supposed
this land
to be
is
said.
Your land. This land. Is my land.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Leave that. Don't overdo it. It's disgusting.
So, Sai, I find it really interesting that you're wearing a t-shirt that has my pet name on it.
Which is?
Fifi.
Fifi.
My parents used to call me that as a child. And Cyrus right now is wearing a t-shirt.
Isn't it an island? No, that's Fiji, you
that's
idiot.
Fiji.
God. So bad.
That says Bombay Gym Rugby.
Listen, our 36 regular listeners all know because I wear only one or two shirts.
Oh, so this t-shirt's worn very often.
If I wore something else, you'd be like really excited.
I thought you wore it because you knew it was my pet name because you've done so much research on me before I came.
I'm going to go with that. In spite of the fact that I'm not on the list of famous people you were with. Damn you. I mean, Salman Rushdie. What are you doing with Salman Rushdie?
So, I host events. Huh. And all these people who's
and let me just break in there for a second and say, you've been hosting for many years. And generally, the host's shelf life is not that much. They normally go for about 3-4 years on the circuit and they find someone new. But you're still there at it for 15 years?
No, I've been now hosting events for 10 years.
That's not bad.
And I'm actually just, I'd like to think that I'm pretty much at my strongest right now.
Yeah.
And I'm doing some pretty great events.
And let me tell you, people ask me, but what is there to anchor? You read things out. It's a very difficult thing. They put you under a lot of pressure. There are three or four things I think that no one is prepared for, like stopping someone in the middle of their speech.
Right.
Getting people to, you tell us. Why should I tell them? You tell us. What are the challenges?
So there's a lot of people who will turn around and say, oh, you know, just read from a paper and go on stage and there's nothing else to do.
Yeah.
I'd never read from a piece of paper.
Yeah.
I do a lot of prep before an event.
You don't read from your hand?
You write your notes.
How do you think he got Doland? It was written on the hand. You can see it probably. Yeah.
So I do a lot of prep. I do a lot of preparation. I know exactly what I'm going to say before I get on stage. I don't wing it.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when it's an event and there's that much weighing on you. And also, I mean, why would someone want to pay me money to read from a piece of paper?
That's the other thing. They do pay money.
Well,
I only discovered that a little later in my life. Yeah.
I'm actually really blessed. It's a well-paying job.
But would you call it a career alone without all the other things that you have to do?
It definitely is.
Could you just be
is.
An anchor? Could someone listening to this say, okay, I'll be like Freishia, I'll just be an anchor. I won't act, I won't dance, I won't do anything in the satellite industries around.
You can. In fact, today there's a very strong body. It's
Arnab
called
is an anchor and nothing else.
He is a TV reporter.
Is he?
I mean, he's...
What does he report?
Well, a bunch of screaming things, but yeah.
His script is in place from the beginning of the year. This is no change.
Yeah. But yes, you definitely can. You can be an anchor, and that's all that you can be doing. And there are many people in India doing that right now.
So anchor is more than just a switch, as the ad says.
That's true.
Okay, Freishia.
But it's a switch that's always on.
At least in your case. Okay, now we have to go back and figure out why you got into this whole line, because like I said, this is about you. But I want to ask the Salman Rushdie question first, get out of the way.
Yeah.
Because we've run out of time suddenly and I've forgotten.
So he was here to promote a book. Mm-hmm. He had just gotten divorced. I remember that.
For the 18th time, yeah.
Yeah, with Padma Lakshmi.
Yeah.
And he was here to promote one of his books. And this was for the launch, the India launch of it.
Okay. Do you remember which book? It's obviously not Satanic Verses, because that would be tough.
Huh. No, it wasn't that. But I really can't remember. And it was also very early in my career. I think it was like probably like 9 years back.
Did he flirt with you?
Not at all.
What was he like?
Like, he's like as old as my granddad or something. You know, he's like,
you think men that age don't flirt?
I'm sure they
flirt
do.
With me.
Oh. I'm sure they do. So my interaction with him was very brief, but he was extremely charming, extremely nice,
mm-hmm.
and signed a copy, took a picture. You know, what else do you need? Especially, you know, Sai, when there's an event going on, there's like 500 people over there. Everybody's trying to like clamor for someone's attention. Everyone's like, you know, there's too much happening. So a one-on-one conversation does not happen.
Mm-hmm.
Unless the event is about that.
But he didn't slip his phone number to you?
When he signed it?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Hotel Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal. Room number.
Yeah.
Come meet me 8 p.m.
And didn't ask for conveyance and those kind of things. It also can be quite cheap.
Yeah. No.
So
we didn't
experience.
Go down that way.
Any bad experiences out of these lists of stars? Should I name them again?
Who's
the worst behaved? What's the fun of a podcast
behaved.
If you're doing good things?
No, that's fine. I'm just trying to think
Hrithik,
about
Sachin,
if anyone
Sef,
was...
Karina, Salman, Ajay Devgan.
Oh, you know who was the worst
Priyanka.
Behaved? Now, I don't know if it was any... He's not in this list. I haven't updated this list in a very long time.
Okay.
So, I was doing an event with a particular cricketer.
Okay.
And
right-hander, left-hander?
Let's just not do any guesses right
Off
now.
Off-break, leg-break.
And I don't know if it was any fault of his or I don't know what was going on. But they told me that he was here and I had to introduce him and he was going to come on stage.
Right.
And I got really close to saying his name because he was a surprise factor. Nobody at the event knew he was coming.
Right.
We had 1,000 people over there.
Hmm.
And then I get like this frantic wave from the back and somebody going, no.
This is something anchors have to do. Now hold the whole show because the idiot's not turned up.
For how long?
But they do, don't they?
I did it for 30 minutes.
Wow.
Because they kept telling
but
me.
But did you say half the
okay,
name?
Okay, he's here. No, I didn't. Okay, he's here. And then again, somebody would wave out and say, he's not here. And for 30 minutes,
why was he
this went on.
Was he lost in the hotel? Was
because
it
like, he had never shown up.
He didn't come.
And finally he came. Hmm. But he came 1 hour later. And for 30 minutes, I was just doing stupid things with the audience.
Okay.
Thinking that he's going to show up. So that's another skill
okay,
that
I'll
you need.
I'll tell you what. So let's play a game where you don't tell me the name of the cricketer. But I'll give you a rhyming word. You tell me if it's that
okay,
guy.
Okay, he's the prince of cricket.
Yuvraj? Is that the right answer?
Mm.
I'm really stupid.
I mean, it was a really easy guess once I said that.
But Yuvraj is quite nice.
No, I'm trying to say is that maybe it wasn't his fault. Because you have to also understand there is...
Sometimes it's not their fault.
There's
just
so many
orders.
Layers. Exactly, yeah. Right? There's so many layers of people. Somebody coordinating, some event person, your manager, then another manager.
But did you talk to him later about it?
I didn't get to because I mean he came. We
you
had
need
to just
complaint
do
here
the
with
thing.
Me. I will deal with this. I will make
will
sure
you
he gets
call
a complaint.
Him?
Yes,
poor
he's,
guy.
He's quite nice. He's a nice guy. Actually, he gets
is.
A lot of bad press. Sometimes they think he's arrogant and all because for whatever reason, it's a bit like a Ravi Shastri used to get bad press when he was a cricketer for no reason.
Right.
Yeah. So
but you think that also just happens because you know people don't really know you. Then there's like this misconstrue of information that's passing on, and then no one really knows.
I think Janta just decided to judge because he's a good-looking guy and slightly, you know. Hero material in the way he walks or whatever. I mean, he's a hanger guy because of his personality.
Listen, but
it's ridiculous.
He's very inspiring. Like his whole journey
the
about cancer.
Story and all
exactly.
That. Listen, he was a fine batsman. One of them.
Yeah.
Since you love your cricket, Freishia, I know that you'll agree with me. He was one of the finest strikers of a cricket ball that I've ever seen in my life. And I've seen him live. And in my hometown Oval, he has a record of sending the ball across the road, which no one has done.
Yeah.
As a 14 or 15 year old boy.
When
he was staying in Dilip Vengsarkar's house and being fed once a day. You know, Maharashtrians don't like to feed.
Unlike
Punjabis. Punjabis feed. Maharashtrians don't feed. You could reverse it. Then Yuvraj would have eaten a lot. But if you come to our part of the world, it's like nashta. And that's it. After that, fend for yourself. True story.
So, yeah. So that happened. But pretty much everyone else has been so polite.
Who can get on our show for
Achha, from this whole list?
Yeah, I'll name you, tell me. Salman you'll get?
Salman Rushdie. Now see, I...
Not Rushdie. Rushdie also. I will take either. Salman Rushdie, Salman Khan.
Any of them will do.
Just the driving experiences of both.
The thing with Salman Khan is that you'll have to go to Panvel.
Why? He lives there.
Apparently.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's what I heard.
That's not worth it.
I don't even know why all those people gather outside his house. He's never there. Do they not realize?
That's the ultimate bakra. They all come for darshan. There's nobody there.
Yeah.
And so, they perform and they scream. Bye.
Every Sunday they're there. But who's going to tell them he doesn't live there?
Bye. And the other two brothers come out. And they're like, nahi, nahi. Salman.
Tu nahi. Woh dusra
wala. Unnecessary. Risha, come on. Okay, Shahrukh. I would desperately want Shahrukh.
Oh, I've done a lot of events with him.
Can you get him?
And I've done an ad with him.
Can you make the call?
I'll call him
Stop showing off. Just tell me what you can do for us.
I'll call him right now.
Will you?
My dear friend Diya Mirza might come.
Will you get her?
She's a very close friend of mine.
Okay, done. Diya Mirza is a good one. Then, Saif Ali Khan. Because it's cricket also. Because I love sport.
There's that
try?
Whole factor. No.
And I can put it on a British accent also. Just for a second.
All right then, darling.
Tendulkar.
Maybe not.
Why not? What do you do with Sachin?
I've just done one event
with
a lot of them, yeah.
Oh, okay, but
they're not on my speed dial.
So there's no personal interaction that you can tell us with some of these guys that you had? Like, did Sachin give you a tip about how your elbow was pointed towards mid-off when you were batting?
When I was batting and how I know so much about cricket that I would want these tips in life.
I think that'd be great, no? The cricketer just presumes you're a cricketer and just starts telling you
things. Come, let me show you how to do this.
Show me your posture, yeah.
Oh, that sounds, like Kunal telling you, come on, let's cook.
Kunal can't cook. Kunal is not my Kunal, no? Fatso.
Yeah, there is only one Kunal.
The other Kunal is now more famous, Kamra.
Right.
Yeah, he's the philosopher who attacked the comedian.
Right.
In that famous incident.
In that famous incident that
Indigo.
Happened on an airplane.
You pay for cheap comedy. You don't take those flights. Be careful, they might remember that.
Then they won't come on your show.
Kamra used to work in MTV.
Okay.
He used to work for us.
Okay.
And he was really fat. They showed me a picture of him. I couldn't recognize him.
Hey, you know, Sai, actually, Khatro Ke Khiladi wasn't the only thing we did.
What did we do?
We also did a whole bunch of spoofs.
Yeah, you were on our show, no? The Carl show.
Yeah.
But the reason there's different, not because of talent, of course there's talent, but that wasn't the reason. The reason was she was the girlfriend of the producer and he wants to save money. Because
and
he
the director.
MTV is all about saving money. Half the actors in any shot we did, the light man is standing in the back. The one who's playing the father is probably a spot. It's like that. There's like one VJ and half an actress is only that we manage. Yeah.
That's true.
It was a fun shoot.
It was an in-house production.
Yeah. And Carl, Carl was crazy. He still is.
He acted in it also.
Oh,
did he?
Yeah. There's one thing that he did. We must give him credit, called Raju.
Okay.
Do you remember the Raju vignettes?
No.
They're hilarious. So Raju would just solve problems. He was the servant called Raju.
Huh.
Like if the husband and wife couldn't conceive, then Raju.
My God.
They call Apna Raju. And Apna Raju lands in the middle of the bed and he tells Saukar, his husband, he tells the husband, "Aap aram karo."
Huh.
And pushes him that way, facing the other way. And he jumps in under the... you were the girl. Weren't you the girl?
I can't remember this at all.
No. Tanvi. Tanvi was the girl. Now I remember.
Just some name.
It's ridiculous. But this Apna Raju character, I used to love it. Because for some obscure reason, he would land up in wherever. Your health is bad or whatever, he'd help cure it. It's like that. There was no reason to it.
That's
husband's genius.
Exactly. That's what I was
going to
say.
That short, midget, half Parsi, half Malayali, curly head monkey called Carl Kadgara. I hope I've abused all of India in one sentence. The letters can start pouring in. Yeah, now back to you.
Yeah.
So, Katrina,
other than my events, let's talk about something else. I do so much more.
No, listen, I want to trace the journey of young Miss Bomanbehram. Firstly, why don't you keep the Kadgara surname? What's that story?
So, after I got married and my sister got married, we realized that the Bomanbehram name...
Will go. There's no male.
And also, I've just never believed
in
changing...
What's with that name crap,
yeah? I've never believed in changing my surname.
I agree with you.
And there is no need.
I think anyone listening, please tell us what your thoughts are on this, because I've told my daughter also. I think, quite frankly, she must keep her name.
You know, I want to tell you a funny story about this.
If it's not funny, that's pressure. Always say the story and then... Okay, go.
Oh, then you'll decide if
it's funny.
I know,
because people write it and say it wasn't funny.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, I've got a couple of laughs every time I've said it. So you're not the first one.
We've got Deep, you've got Silvery.
Okay.
In the audience here, if they laugh, you've cut it.
Wonderful.
Let's go.
Boys, laugh. Okay.
Yeah. They're not boys. Look at them.
So, went to change my passport. I needed a new passport.
When you went to change your passport, yeah. You've had enough of India.
No, don't
judge by the Trump body here section. There's more to our country than one bad speech. Yeah.
So I had to renew my passport and I'm standing in line and the passport officer actually calls me while he's still talking to somebody else.
Right.
And he looks at me and he says, देखो हमारा देश कितना बढ़ रहा है यहाँ पे ये जो मैडम आई है वो सेक्स चेंज के लिए आई है वो अपने पासपोर्ट में मिस्टर से मिसेस बनने वाली है और देखो हमारे देश में कितना प्रोग्रेस हुआ है सो आई एम प्रीटी डैम इम्प्रेस्ड एंड आई एम लाइक वाओ ग्रेट एक्सट्रीमली इम्पर्सनल फॉर हिम टू हैव डन दैट आई मीन टू शेयर दिस काइंड ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन
इट्स लाइक कॉल अ क्राउड एंड हैव अ लिटिल सेशन आई मीन दैट वाज अ बिट टू मच आई थॉट
आई वाज द ओनली पर्सन दैट ही कॉल्ड बट आई स्माइल्ड पोलाइटली आई टोल्ड हर कांग्रेचुलेशंस
बट व्हाट वाज द मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग
वेट इट्स कमिंग
द पेशेंस इश्यूज प्रीमैच्योर
सो दे हैव हैड दिस मोमेंट ही इज वेरी प्राउड ऑफ himself and the lady leaves and now it's my turn and I say that okay I'm just getting this passport renewed da 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 da, da. And I said I'm married so my last passport had it as Miss Bomanbehram
correct
now I would like it to say that I'm Mrs. Bomanbehram and there is a section over there where it just says married to Karl Katgara and he said but aise kaise ho sakta hai
But it is a confusing point now. Come on, you can't blame him.
It's not. There's nothing confusing.
Your maiden name is one. Your surname would change. We can see the husband's name there.
Yeah.
So it's obvious that for him, you haven't explained it to him properly.
There's no confusion. I'm married to Karl Katkara.
But you want to retain your name.
But I want to retain my name.
Yeah.
Nahin, aise nahin ho sakta.
How dare?
So I said, arey, lekin India to matlab bahut progress ho raha hai India mein. To abhi aise kaise nahin ho sakta.
Male to female, theek hai sir.
But you cannot not change your name. Sai. He... called Carl
to get permission from the male
on the phone.
Wow,
he called
what a fascist,
him
sexist.
He asked him whether it was okay.
I hope Carl said no just to screw
with
you.
One minute then he turned around and said, but how do I know that I did talk to your husband? What if you just put somebody else on the phone?
Apna Raju.
So he made me fax him a letter from
Carl. Are you
kidding me? All this is happening at the passport office. 2-3 years later, the laws changed. Legally now,
as a woman
in India, you can have your maiden name. And there is a section that is now in the new passports.
How can anybody decide what your name should be?
Correct.
It's not their business whether you're married or not married. You decide your name.
And look at how he's first called me to say that India has progressed. And then he turns around and tells me I can't change my name.
I mean, I know Govinda was denied a visa to America once because his name is Chichi. And he insisted on being Chichi and somebody wrote Govinda on the passport. And there was a lot of confusion.
Right.
But Chichi is his name.
But that's
the name he wants. Listen,
but
you may find it funny,
legally...
but you got to respect the person's identity. What we are is what we are.
Okay, but does his like birth certificate say Chichi?
There's no certificate. He came third. Only the first two got certificates.
So,
in Virar, yeah.
Yeah, so
no,
but that's the kind of, yeah, the kind of stuff that goes down.
Ridiculous story.
Isn't it?
It has to be true. It just doesn't make sense otherwise.
It is. It very
but
much
I agree
is.
With you. Are you a feminist?
You know, what a convoluted word. And I mean,
husband,
how are we supposed to say I'm a feminist?
Your husband and
I'm
fathers
not.
And men around you may not be that sexist. So then it's tough to be a feminist.
Also, growing up as a Parsi child.
You didn't get that kind
you
of
You know, you don't get that
negativity.
Kind of treatment.
Yeah. Because Parsi women are very tough.
We are.
And they beat us silly with their chappals. Sometimes left, right, at the same time. And that's how Zakir
We can see
born.
The bruises on you already.
I do have bruises, but not from that. My wife has bruises on her face. They think I've beaten her. Because she fell while running.
She's
a marathoner, no?
Oh, no.
Yeah, every day she leaves home and comes back. Yeah.
That's fun. I ran my first marathon 3 years back.
Really? 42?
So I'm sponsored by Adidas.
What a show-off. I mean, where does this come from?
Okay, I mean,
good to know.
You know, I just want to go beyond this list of celebrities that we have over here.
What do you mean? Oh, we have to take a break. You've talked so much. So, sponsored by Adidas?
Yes.
We're looking for a sponsorship. We'll take a break and we'll come back. You talk to them right now. Bring the phone.
Arjun.
Arjun, head of Adidas answered.
Hi, I'm Sariyu Natarajan.
And I'm Alok Prasanna Kumar.
And we are the hosts of the Ganatantra podcast.
On this podcast, we speak to academics, social scientists, journalists and activists to find out what's actually going on in Indian politics.
On this podcast, we stay away from personality politics, intrigue and gossip and instead focus on the data, research and analysis that drives all this.
So tune in to the Ganatantra podcast, where new episodes are out every Wednesday on the IVM podcast app, website or wherever you listen to your podcasts.
Yes, Freishia is talking to us. Freishia BB, Bomanbehram, keeping her name. How's Carl about it? Cool. Never had a problem.
No.
Yeah. I give me some advice. I have my daughter's 13. I've told her the name must stay. Or like Arancha Vicario Sanchez, the famous tennis player from Spain, who kept both names. So that's also, I don't have a problem with that.
My God, can you imagine? Then I would have been Freishia Bomanbehram Katgra.
Fair enough.
I would have run out of space.
I agree with you. You need a bigger passport just for that.
Yeah.
I'm recommending the Canadian one. You take this letter to Mr. Singh in Department 7 there.
Right.
See if we can give you one quickly.
Right.
Okay.
It's actually Carl Vaz for Explore Canada.
Carl Vaz?
Yeah.
Carl Vaz there, you mean?
Yeah.
If you want to,
because I'm trying to do some travel stuff with them.
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about all of it very quickly. So, what do you think about the last word on this subject? Let's not go on about it.
Huh?
Shouldn't women keep their names? I mean, this whole gender bias starts with things like that, I feel personally.
But this is so personal. It's your name.
But
right?
Why can't your identity remain and you get married?
Exactly.
No?
But you should do what
you have retained.
But you should do what you want to do. Like my sister has changed her name, and there's no problem
even
in that.
Even her first name? That was stupid.
Well, you know, actually there was chat about that.
Really?
But
what
she finally...
First name?
No, sometimes they
What's
say...
What's the first name?
Thea. Her name is Thea.
T-H-E-A, ladies and gentlemen.
No, T-H-E-I-A.
Okay, like, come on.
So an atheist is a non-believer in God.
Right.
And a theist... And a theist is someone who believes in God. And
right.
That's where her name comes from.
But can you change God from time to time?
Unfortunately not.
Like, have you changed political affiliations, that kind of thing? No? All right.
Unfortunately not.
Okay, so last word. Girls should not be determined by their husband's surname. I just think that. I hate that. I hate the name Brocha.
But
I
they should it. Do what they want to do. That's it.
Yeah.
Girls, that's what feminism should be about. Just do what you want to do.
And
that's it.
And that's why so many actors have taken new names as you destroy the furniture here for some reason.
Sorry.
In a fit of anger because I dared change my wife's name, she's thrown the headphones onto the wall. Listen, less time, lots to talk about.
Huh.
Now, we've discussed anchoring. We've discussed all these superstars that you've worked with.
Yeah.
But let's go back into your life. How did you land up here? How did you land up in this business? And how do you have such a long and checkered career? Do you pay GST? How much money do you make?
Mm-hmm.
And do you have a joint account with Carl Kirkara? These questions are the questions you have to answer.
I pay GST. I'm a law-abiding citizen. And
in India. Right. You never cut a signal? You never cut a challan?
No.
Never?
Listen, you can't cut signals, please. Yeah, that's very trashy.
Really?
Yeah, come on. We're educated people.
I now hit bikers purposely.
Okay.
Is that allowed?
You know the only time I cut a signal?
Like
you know the only time I cut a signal is I was driving. I was on the highway.
Yeah.
A man was crossing and a car came and hit him.
Yeah,
okay?
Died?
And no, he didn't. I stopped my car. I physically picked him up. I took
him. Was he really small? Sorry to be insensitive, but
Cyrus, he was bleeding really badly.
Really? That bad?
Yeah.
Okay, let me get the appropriate sensitivity in my voice.
And that's when I had to jump a signal and I told the cop I had a bleeding guy.
Who was this guy? Who was he?
Papa, I don't know. I didn't take his number. I took him to the hospital.
Which hospital?
We went to some hospital in Goregaon. I took him over there.
I just mapped and dropped. Same hospital.
Yeah, but you know, Sai, it got me into trouble.
But the police don't take the...
Exactly.
They can't take the person in until the police have signed off on it. So you'll have to be there,
No. So it got me into a little bit of trouble because everybody assumed that I had hit the guy.
They always do.
Right? And
that's
a woman
never be
driver...
A good Samaritan.
A woman driver, so then you've got that cliche also and that bias on you.
And although it's completely true, I hate it.
Yeah.
I'm kidding. But I have seen women struggle with parking. I have.
You know, but it's
true. Especially parallel parking, waiting to put your car in and then you're just waiting and waiting.
Yeah, but there's sometimes that even I've abused a few women and I've gone like, come on, girl.
I mean, you're giving girls a bad name, man.
Yeah.
You can't park, take an Uber.
Yeah.
As I told Salman the other day.
But I've seen some men also park very badly.
Yes, but there are also men who are metrosexual. So they're on the line of actual control. And
hey, there's nothing wrong with being a metrosexual.
I wouldn't know. I'm so dirty, I can't tell you. I'm the last of the bums. So you took the guy to hospital and then this is an interesting story again. Happens to a few people. Not worth it in a way.
And then you feel that,
except
you know, I'm
guy.
Not going to do this again because it can get me into trouble, blah, blah, blah. Luckily, the man that I took to the hospital was not unconscious. He was just bleeding really badly.
And he saw your pretty face and said, hit me again.
And then the doctor was like, ye madam ne tumhe mara. Ye madam ne tumhe mara.
Are you kidding? Like, with aggro?
No, but he was just like...
Look at the prejudices you're pointing out.
You
it's
need
so funny.
To tell us.
But they are almost coaching him into saying that the slightly rich-looking, well-heeled, westernized Indian
woman
female,
who has rescued
self-driving,
you
know, all these things are going against you. Do you understand? In the complexes of our culture. It's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
This is why I love Trump's speech.
beautiful.
Speech.
But I'll tell you
on
what.
DDLJ.
I'll do it again.
I cried. Sorry?
He, Trump made a speech on DDLJ.
He spoke about 2 minutes just on the movie and the effects of the film and how he couldn't afford popcorn because
did
he spent
know?
So much on nuclear reactors.
Did you know
India.
That if you go to Mount Titlis in Switzerland.
Titlis!
Yeah.
Don't
I knew you'd
wrong.
Like that word.
Yes, I took pictures. Pisaab karna mana hai. Are you telling me that story?
No, there is Shahrukh and Kajol.
Yes, 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 right in the
from
beginning.
From DDLJ, right over there, as soon as you get off this escalator that's taken you all the way to the top of the mountain.
Because 50% of the money that came into Switzerland came from Yash Chopra Productions.
Right.
The other 50% came from black money, which is supposed to come back to us 15 lakhs a person.
Right.
I'm waiting, Shri Pradhan Mantri. I have not received my money. Please call up the Prime Minister's office. My money is not coming. From
he might just be a little busy right now.
Right now.
Just a bit.
With Doland.
With Donald.
Doland Trump. You heard about Doland Trump, no? Everybody? Yeah. I'm just saying it like it is. We have no idea. Yeah. What's in a name anyway?
Nothing.
Except that
just your own identity.
Retain your own.
Yeah.
Freishia, you're freewheeling so much, I can't get into your life.
Huh?
How do you get into this? How do you get here? That's the whole story.
Okay. So, I come from a theatre background.
But
and I was doing... Now, let me say the story.
No, no, but what were... Like the parents and all, just give us a little background. Before theatre, what were you going to do as a young girl?
Okay, so I went to Jai Hind College.
Oh, my God.
And I was in Bai Awabai Framji Petit Girls High School.
Oh, that's quite the hoity-toity Bandra West experience.
Totally.
With lots of Parsi girls and elitist English-speaking ma'am, so Shana's Treasury Wala, who's now Shana's Treasury.
So one minute, Shana's Treasury Wala's mum is the reason that I did theatre.
Drama, no?
Yeah.
Drama,
lovely
lady. Yeah.
And I did my first professional theatre play when I was 6 years old. We ran for 4 years. Every summer holiday, we ran this one play where I played
you'll be
the dancing
seven
doll.
The next year, so you can't play the same character again.
So I grew
by
outgrew.
By 8, you'd be like a woman.
I outgrew the character.
I'm sure. By 10, you're like a grandmother.
They had this little dancing doll cage for me, and every year they had to make the cage bigger and bigger.
Really? But Awabai, what do you do for the male characters?
No, so this was a professional play. So we had children from different schools.
Oh, okay.
All there was a man called Hosi Vasunia.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Huh. And Hosi Vasunia produced that play.
Right. I like to really say a man called, huh?
A gentleman.
Huh.
She and her sister, being Shana's Treasurywala's mom.
Yeah.
They
played Tina,
no? No, that's her sister.
I'm just trying to show off that I know everybody.
You don't know these
there's
people.
There's 32 Parsis left. I know 17. Come on, can't be that hard. Google the rest.
So anyways, long story short, I started my theatre career at the age of 5.
In a cage.
In a cage. And I always knew that it was something I wanted to do.
Right.
Went to Jai Hind. Over there, I got my first job when I was 15, by the way. I worked my way through college.
What were you doing? This is not America. This is an American experience. Where are you working in Jai Hind?
So, did you know there was I know you know him. There was a gentleman called Jules Fuller.
Of course.
Yes.
MTV, no? Oh, Channel V. Correct.
Channel V.
Yeah, lovely guy. Bass guitarist also, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. And I was Jules' PA. I was his personal assistant.
Oh.
And I learned so much from him, right? Just being around an inspiring person like that.
Yeah.
Him
very
and
self-deprecating
his...
fellow. Good fun. I remember. I've drunk with Jules a couple of times. Cheers, Jules. Wherever the hell you are, where is he?
He's in England. I'm still in touch with him. He's my first boss ever. And it was for me to work with him and just realize...
Would you keep his surname Fuller?
That anything is possible.
Freishia Fuller. No? I don't know.
Does it have a ring to it? I feel like it does have a ring to it.
You sound like a scientist or something. One of those famous people who invented the atom, you know, something like that.
Yeah.
Dr. Fuller. Hello, how are you? Dr. Fuller's consulting. Yeah, call you back. So it was all the normal theatre bug thing. And
it was a theatre bug.
Fuller,
then
so
I met Jules. No, by then he was almost getting out of Channel V.
He
was setting up his own bunch of channels.
Right.
And I was assisting him. I mean, I was his PA. So I literally did things from get his laundry to also work on conceptualizing.
Now,
pick up his
here's
laundry.
The point, Freishia, where we must ask you the question that nobody's asking, the elephant in the room. Many people think Western men, European men especially, don't wear underwear.
Okay.
As the PA who did the laundry, I want the truth. Did Jules Fuller use underwear, yes or no?
It didn't go for laundry.
So they do use underwear, they just don't change it.
The point is that there was never any of that coming in the laundry list.
You've done your bit for Indo-Anglo relations for sure. We don't need to call Boris Johnson and have another meeting in Ahmedabad with 7 million people when there's only 5 million people in the city. Which is begs the question, where do you get the other 2 million from? That's one. Two is in the end, it was about 100,000 people who were watching and waiting for DDLJ to actually start because the speeches were too long.
But then they went to Mount Titlis and took a picture.
Ooh, it's Titlis.
Titlis.
You're saying Titlis.
Titlis.
It's literally without tit.
Yeah.
Titless. Not it. A tit.
It has it, not has it.
I don't know how else to say it. Me and the family sat under that. I mean, my son was like 12, but he was like all over the place. He was falling. You know, how can you have a name like that?
I know.
There's some names that shouldn't be out there, like London Blockley.
Yeah.
I just cannot bear that name. I've said it on stage. I don't know if you ever had, and I'm like, no way.
No, thankfully, I've never had to say that.
My God.
But there are a couple of, you know, Indian surnames also that can just go like, and you're like, oh no, I have to say this.
Yeah.
And
can you remember which?
No. No.
Come on, say it.
No, I can't. I genuinely can't.
You won't get the gig again. What's the worst thing? That's other work.
No.
It was sponsored by Adidas, you said. What does that mean?
Oh, what it means is that
when you run, they pay for you.
No. So 3 years back, Adidas launched a campaign.
Keep in mind, like Sachin Tendulkar and some of the great NBA basketballers are all Adidas guys. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what are you giving them?
Can I finish it? Then I'll tell you.
All right. Some people say I talk too much.
So 3 years back, Adidas launched a campaign where they took 5 women who had never run in their lives.
But that's not you.
I was never a runner.
Huh, but
yeah,
I would expect them to take like really unathletic sort of, you know, large-ish.
No, the idea was not. The idea was
to
get
from the comedy shows, that kind of, yeah, sorry. Lovely girl though.
The idea was to get people onto a fitness journey, which involved running.
Mm-hmm.
And then they made us run our, we didn't run a full marathon or a half marathon. We just did 10 kilometers.
Poor man's marathon.
Yeah, poor man's
marathon. When you live in a small country,
it's the one
you can't afford to go any further.
There is no other place to run.
5 kilometer ka hai. Main kya karega? Do run. North, west, east, south, gone, finished. That sounds a little complex.
Yeah.
My wife's quite this thing, Mandarin about all this. Be careful.
Does she travel to? Oh, wow.
They're going to Chicago. My pop has to pay for it. He's in a wheelchair, so I have to pay for it. Right. Technically, yeah.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. C'est la vie. Life goes on. Yeah.
So that's what happened. And ever since then, my association with them has been pretty strong. And I mean, I run.
But again, I find you odd for that.
Why?
Because I thought they should get some middle class housewives who really, you're the ones you've seen hanging gardens in their salwar kameez and shoes and all. You know, they've never run.
No, the idea also was to just get women from different walks of life.
So who are the other four?
Okay, so there was one girl who was
an
actor.
Mamta Banerjee?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just thinking. Okay, you go first.
There was one girl who was an actor. There was another girl who was a lawyer. Then there was somebody who was the marketing head of Estee Lauder.
Because they're not famous people. They're just from a profession.
They're women from different walks of life. And they don't really have... No one was like famous.
Okay.
But we were just people from different walks of life who came together, trained, and ran.
But you have to... What if you wear Nike? Is it okay?
I can't wear Nike.
You have to wear Adidas.
I have to only wear
Adidas.
And
even the shirts and pants and all can't be other brands? Like whatever?
No, of course they can. Only my athleisure wear cannot be any other brand.
What if you wear Adidas, but you wear Nike around your neck? You know, like how the
Nike
West Indian
doesn't
fast
make
bowlers
used
to come.
For your neck.
No, you try shoes. You know the track guys in Jamaica and all, they always walk in. It's a very macho thing to do. They don't wear it on their feet.
Okay.
They wear the track shoes only on their neck with the thing tied.
Hmm.
And then they take off their loafers or whatever and put it on.
No,
and
luckily.
Usain Bolt runs at 9.58.
So luckily, no, we don't have any of those problems.
Damn it.
I just
thought of you as an athlete from Jamaica.
That's imagine me doing that.
You're like the Chris Gayle of my dreams.
Suddenly, Yeah, so you didn't expect this, huh?
No, I didn't.
This whole running thing.
No, I didn't at all.
Yeah.
Because I'm a Khatru ki khiladi.
Also because
us.
My bio doesn't say it.
It doesn't say it. And also I spent 3 weeks with you. So I vaguely know that, you know, you weren't into the whole sporty experience that much.
That's true. Here it is. It's right here in the last line.
I can't see the font.
There we go.
We've got a new producer.
Silvani,
how old are you? He's 27.
See,
he's my son's age.
Basically, you stopped with the first paragraph.
Yeah, I got tired.
Then there was two more paragraphs.
It's too much.
And the last line says, I was the face of Stay Free India's digital YouTube.
Stay Free is a sanitary napkin.
Yeah, I was the face
of their... How could you be the face of a napkin? I mean, that's wrong.
So I ran another campaign with them.
My God. So now she has to wear the sari napkin, whether it's that time of the month or not. She's wearing the Adidas shoe, whether she wants to run or not. I mean, these guys, these corporates are taking over your life, Freshia. I can't be part of this. I refuse.
And
you sold your name.
I quickly want to call Apple and ask them if they want to do anything with me as well.
They won't answer our phones. Listen, I want to ask you, if you had to choose between Baman and Behram and keep only one name for your surname, which one would you keep and why?
Are Baman, no?
Because it's easier.
Because Behram sounds little
Behram's
odd.
Very Parsi, but...
It's a name
Baman
also.
Because of Baman Irani becoming famous,
I mean,
is sort of known.
I know a couple
of
Behrams.
But they keep saying Bowman.
Yeah,
people
no.
People call you and say, do you know Bowman? So I now just say, I've never heard this word before.
Bowman
Irani. Like Roman. What is it, Bowman?
Yeah.
It's not Bowman!
It's Baman
it's
Irani.
It's like your bottom bum.
He's a great guy. I've done a lot of events with him.
Yeah, 6'2".
But he's just so charming. And
you haven't mentioned him, by the way.
He's so endearing. I know, I told you this
list
has...
mentioned, Salman mentioned, Saif mentioned, Kareena Kapoor.
I stopped updating this list.
Really?
I stopped updating this list a long time back.
Okay, listen, quickly.
But listen, quickly. There's one more thing we need to really talk about.
Your travel shows and all that.
Oh, my travel shows, right. That's there. But I also really want to talk about my YouTube channel. My own YouTube channel.
That's why we brought her here. Now I remember where my pills, where my medication. That's it. All right. So what's the YouTube channel about and what's it called?
Okay, so the channel's called Whack.
Whack.
It's over there. It's in that paper.
Give me a just minute. I'll find it slowly with my eyes.
I'll tell you about it. Let the paper be.
Unbelievable. Yeah.
So I have a YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. It's called Whack.
Right.
And it's a mix of science, technology, thinking things. Basically, what happened is that there were a lot of like really like crazy concepts out there.
Like the Industrial Revolution, 1712.
No, that now you've done in your history
book. I'm just asking. I don't know anything. I'm just asking. Help me.
Yeah. Like, you know, this whole thing about gravitational waves came out. And then there were just all these
controversial
other
stuff.
No, I'm not saying political.
Like, is there a Yeti or not? I know there's a Mr. Mehra in my building who looks like one.
Who looks like one? Yeah. Great, we found him. I'll do that on my next episode. So it's basically just a mix of science, technology, facts.
Tell me, so is it like
things that you need to...
Is it the gray area questions or is it just everything?
It's everything.
Okay.
And then I would just do like a whole bunch of like fun videos with that, you know, crazy facts about something, five facts about something.
Like, why do
breaking down concepts on certain things.
Can
a little bit of political
so
stuff, but not...
So check out the YouTube. Can you give us an example?
So, like I said, like that whole thing about gravitational waves had come out like 4 years back and mm-hmm. everyone was just wondering what that whole thing was.
Right.
So I said, okay, as a lay person who has absolutely no knowledge on science or has studied the subject well, I said, how am I going to break it down and understand it? And then I made a video on it just as any lay person should understand
it. Is it Adnan Sami's lift karade?
That makes waves as it goes through.
Sort of, and there's a gravitational element to it. But
then there's also a lot of fun videos, right? Like the biggest video that I have on that, which has a couple of million views.
Wow.
Which is on...
Couple of million views? What are you doing, man? for some stupid science experiment, which has got 2 million views. I take my clothes off and speak in dialects that nobody's heard of and I get nothing.
That's just a fun video that I made where I wanted to just talk about the differences between North India and South India.
Wow.
And you know,
and you got the whole of Bengal to listen. So 2 million views. Huge.
Yeah. Something like that. No, it's a little more than two.
So you do everything piece to camera. There's nobody else involved?
There's piece to camera. And then, so I write the script, I research it, I shoot it, and then I get somebody to edit it because.
No, I mean, on camera, is there anyone talking to you with you?
No.
Scientists, analysis, data,
no.
Questions, aam aadmi, nothing like that.
Nothing.
So it's just
nothing.
You.
But wow. I'm thinking.
Also,
that
take notes. This is how you make a YouTube channel rock. Yeah, okay. Just keep shooting her. We'll just put her on our channel. 1 million? 1 million?
1 million, yeah. Definitely. You know, he's saying 2, yeah.
Well, we are beggars. We'll take the 1 million and run. 2 million is too much.
So, yeah, that's what it's all about.
Whack. What do you think the person coming in watching you would be what? What do you think? Who would be your customer or your viewer?
So, my TG mostly is...
TG. Damn you, old man. Who's your TG?
Who's your customer? Hi, madam. Today I want to sell you one YouTube channel.
Can I interview your grandmom? Obviously, the references are all over the place. TG.
So my TG definitely, and it has turned out to be, let's put it that way. Because also, you don't start a YouTube channel saying, oh, I'm going to talk to these people.
Or maybe you do, but it just gets organic and
it becomes organic, it finds its own voice, and then you find yourself talking to a particular audience. Yeah. The audience that I cater to...
Why do we have pedophiles? You just check that out. There must be a reason. Sorry.
The audience that I cater to is a male demographic from the... No guesses there.
Wow.
From the age group of...
We have the same demographic, sadly. You've taken mine.
18 to 35.
Wow.
No, but 1 minute. Do you know why we all have the same male demographic?
Because
they're the ones who are surfing and they're the ones... And this is what
true,
I don't understand.
Is that true that nobody over 35 surfs?
No, I'm talking about the male part.
The male part?
Yeah, because...
Mount Titlis to you.
Well, demographically, what they say is that more men are consuming statistics, numbers. I mean, I was listening to Joe Rogan talking to Joe Preston.
Yeah.
And
we got the Rogan right for sure, huh?
What is his name?
Joe Rogan.
No.
It's Kashmiri. Joe Rogan. Josh.
Yes, Joe Rogan. And what they were saying is that statistically, more men consume the internet and are on
You're on the internet. My wife's on the internet. His girlfriend's on the internet. They're all, I mean, is that true?
I don't know. I wonder what this is. But I definitely know that I have more men that are interested in finding out about
wrong.
These things.
Yeah, all right. No wonder you can retain your surname. Poor Karl Kadgara.
No.
Sitting there, lonely old man, having walked out of his 54th job because they spoke to him rudely.
Who are your customers?
I have no customers. I hired this young man who's he's bleeding me.
So who are you?
I pay him and we have no money.
So who's your TG then?
I don't have a TG. I don't know. Anyone I can make fun of, I suppose.
Uh-huh.
And then they never come back.
Yeah.
Except the relatives who are forced to stay. So we want to live off your TGs. We're parasites, but not the Korean film that won the Oscar, which my mother hated.
I think you should come on WAC. It'll be great
I'll
fun.
I'll go on WAC.
You should
Do
come
I have to travel
WAC.
To any part of Bombay like
no,
that?
No, I live in Bandra.
Oh, I can
you
make Bandra.
Come here.
I'm here anyway.
You're here anyways.
Yeah.
I'll come here and shoot.
Superb, done.
Even better.
WAC.
Yeah.
Let's set it up.
Let's set it up.
Talk to my PA. Mr. Fuller. He's there somewhere in the background. Listen, we're running out of time. Very quickly before we do AMAs, travel shows. What else is there on your... Because there's a lot of things that we haven't mentioned.
Yeah.
One line each. Come on.
So, really quickly, we'll talk about my travel stuff as well.
Mm-hmm.
I do a
and
lot of...
you're a travel
of,
bug, aren't you?
I
so is your husband. You
totally
just love traveling.
Am.
Yeah.
But also what happens is that as an MC and a live host...
MC
I get
doesn't
to,
mean a Punjabi gali. MC is a master of ceremonies.
Master of ceremonies.
People don't understand sometimes.
That's true. Also, a lot of people spell it... You know what really irritates me is when people spell it as E-M-C-E.
Yeah, what is that?
It's word that doesn't
French?
Exist.
French? But what about clubs? Clubs have MCs and BCs. Balloting committee and... You know, so that's MCBC, MCBC. They always talk about it. Hey, you went to the MCBC.
Yeah, and I'm just like, that word doesn't exist. Can you please not...
M-E-M-C-E-E. Put it in whack.
It's M...
This is also a scientific question.
Are
why?
Baba, it's just M and C apostrophe
Maybe it's
S.
Gujarati.
Master
See?
Of Ceremonies. Bas tej chhe. Biju kai na
I don't know. What about anchor? Anchor is a nice easy way.
Anchor?
A-N-C-H-O-R.
Anchor. Nahi.
Bolna dikhe jaldi.
So, my travel... So, because of my emceeing and because of my hosting, I get to travel a lot
Correct.
Around the world.
Mm-hmm.
And I get to go to some pretty cool places.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I do travel for NDTV Good Times, now known as Good Times.
Right.
And I've also done a series with Times Now and Mirror Now. And so it all kind of just
it's
comes
kind of
together.
Confusing. Good Times, Times Now, two separate channels sounding like cousins. I want Good Times and Times Now.
No.
But you just said Good Times.
Yeah.
I get it.
But the Good Times are now.
Why can't you work in Republic? It's clearly different.
You get
to travel every day to either Ahmedabad or Delhi and you come back. It's great.
Yeah.
Everybody's happy.
Yeah. I actually got an offer to do something with them. I had to politely
To abuse
turn.
Pakistan?
I had to politely
what,
turn
What was
down.
The audition? Blame Pakistan for the laundry bill.
We didn't even go there.
Okay, so next.
That's the
things.
Whole travel bit that happens, and that's how it happens.
Ads. You've done a lot of ads.
I did. Nothing anymore.
That's
nothing
okay.
Anymore.
But just tell us a few of them quickly. Were you in the VIP underwear ad?
No.
And that was 70s. Were you in the Robin Hood underwear ad?
No.
80s. Liberty underwear? 90s. No underwear ad.
That's basically what it is.
I auditioned for an underwear ad.
They said
only top off.
Hey, but Sai, you're looking so fit. You might get
underwear.
One now.
Oh,
come on,
I'm squatting.
Yeah.
I'm doing but partial squats, 475 pounds I did.
You know, but that's
half
also...
Half squat, 350.
Huh.
And full range squat, I only go 2 plates.
Not so bad.
Just under 200 pounds.
Not bad.
I want to
that's
show you,
another thing we
I want
share
to show you my thighs
in common.
The other day, somebody said, hey, but you don't do legs. I took my pant off in front of everyone.
Oh, my.
Yeah. I took my pant off. And there were two women inside the dressing room where we were.
Huh.
And they waited, They liked my legs.
Ooh.
I mean, I don't want to make a me too shit, but they didn't run away screaming. You know, they didn't say noodles or Maggie noodle or something like that. You know, nothing. I can pose well now. I'll show you because I have nothing else to do.
Right.
My TG is my mirror.
Is your mirror
every day? I'm like mirror.
And your gym.
Yeah. Well,
yeah.
It's not my gym. I wish it was.
But that's another thing we share in common. Is
the gym?
Yeah, I love working out.
I like a guy called Jim. Does that help? He can't spell.
Hey, but talking about Jim.
Is there any working out thing here? Videos or anything? No, no.
No, but that's all part of my Adidas bit, no?
Oh, correct.
So, it's
so that's
of,
the fitness thing.
It all comes together with that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we've covered everything else. Could
we
tell
have,
me anything
we
more?
We have. No, we've covered everything.
India's digital Stay Free sponsors your show?
No. This was something I did specifically for the Stay Free channel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, last words then on your husband, the lovely Carl.
Why?
Say something about
him. We're here
him.
To talk about
because,
me.
But I rarely do you ever guess I know the husband
First
and everything
First of
else.
All, I just want to also say that he was on your show.
I know.
He had 45 minutes of his own.
You went 46. Carl, take that.
So I didn't come here to have like my 45
That's
minutes
but
about
we discussed
him.
You. We discussed you. He was very sweet.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true. I heard it. Wasn't it one of your top five podcasts of the year?
Out of the six that we did, yes. There in mind, one was with me in the mirror. Yeah, so fair enough. Yeah.
Fair enough.
Okay, listen, we're going to go to the AMAs. Is there anything I've left out? What's Freishia doing next? Let's talk quickly about the future. Is there anything interesting?
Yeah.
If there isn't, can you lie and just make up something?
No. Let me tell you. Next week, I'm going to Australia.
Wow.
I'm going with Brett Lee.
Wow. And how can you go to Brett Lee? He's playing the tournament here.
No, he's going to be in Australia next to next week.
Between the 7th and 22nd, he's contracted to play the Legends Tournament. I just went through the whole thing. Because I have to be the studio anchor.
Anchor there?
So maybe it's after the 22nd.
No.
What is the date you're leaving?
We're headed on the 6th.
Then he's coming back in 2 days?
I guess. I don't know what his schedule is.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah.
He's captaining the Australian team. You're scaring me.
No, he's coming with us. We're going to a place.
I just went through the whole thing yesterday with all these guys. The entire tournament schedule.
Well, either he's ditching you or me.
He can't ditch them. They're paying him.
I think the people that are getting him are also paying.
He's behaving like an Indian. He's taking on two things at the same time.
Maybe it's like he doesn't need to start immediately and he'll come later.
There are matches every day. So he can't be later than, say, 8th or 9th. I can't remember the exact schedule, but definitely on.
So he'll be back by then.
Okay, fair.
7th is our thing.
Why did we go to Brett Lee? Let's go back to you. So you're going to Brett Lee?
No, you asked me what I'm doing
Tourism
next.
Australia, is it?
Yes, we're doing something with them. So one lucky winner I chose a lucky winner.
Who's that?
And this one boy called, he was very randomly chosen from my Instagram. Vasu Chaturvedi, I think his name is.
Okay.
And we ran this contest. Four other influencers along with me ran this contest. We got to choose 1+1, going to Tongaluma Island, where we're going to play cricket with Brett Lee.
Wow. But now he's carrying a little paunch and weight, and he's not as sharp as he used to be. But I would still be careful, because talent is talent. And if you irritate his ego, as I've seen happen with Wasim Akram, he might bowl short and fast. So you tell Vasu to wear AD guard, whatever happens, or there'll be no little Vasus.
So Sai, listen, I need some advice from you. They're giving me 5-10 minutes with him to
he's a great guy. One of the nicest people in the world.
What should I ask him?
You ask him
like
about
you
music.
Know so much about
he plays,
cricket.
He plays lead guitar. He's the singer.
Mm-hmm.
He loves music.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he worked in his name Binga. It comes from the fact that he worked in a one of these trendy shops.
Okay,
selling trendy stuff, metrosexually stuff, jewelry and all that.
Okay,
so that's why they call him Binga. Like bling bing. So
right.
That's his pet name in the Aussie team.
Right. So should I take a ukulele and see if he'll like jam a little with me?
He loves music. Okay, he's performed with Asha, that famous duet that they had done.
Okay.
A little bit of Asha or something. I don't know. What is the song?
Brimful of Asha.
Brimful of Asha. Correct.
Yeah.
So you can ask him about those experiences.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a proper Aussie lad. Yeah. You can ask him about anything of the outbacks and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And he's one of three bowlers to touch 100 miles per hour recorded ever.
Ooh.
Along with Sean Tate, his countryman, and Shoaib Akhtar.
You
can remember that.
I will.
And you can also tell him that, is he distantly related to my other idol, the great Bruce Lee? And with that, we go to the AMAs.
नमस्ते मैं हूँ सौरभ चंद्रा
और मैं प्रणय कोटस्थाने
जब महफिल खत्म होते होते दरवाजे के बाहर पुलिया के ऊपर हम दुनिया भर की जटिल समस्याओं को सॉल्व करने में लग जाते हैं तो हो जाती है पुलियाबाजी
अब आजकल के अपार्टमेंट वालों ने तो कभी पुलिया देखी नहीं होगी पर आप फीलिंग तो समझ ही सकते हैं
तो आइए शामिल हो जाइए हमारी पुलियाबाजी में जहां प्रणय और मैं एक से एक इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक्स की तह तक जाएंगे
आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस बिटकॉइन पाकिस्तान मेडिकल एजुकेशन करेंसी क्राइसिस कभी हम दोनों के साथ और अक्सर स्पेशल एक्सपर्ट गेस्ट की कंपनी में
सुनिए हमें IVM की वेबसाइट ऐप या अपने फेवरेट पॉडकास्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म पर हर दूसरे हफ्ते
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Yeah. All right, back here. Freishia is joined by Silvery, also known as Antariksh.
Yes.
I've got it right at last. Don't ask the story. Please check out any episodes. There are 5 mentions of how you got the name.
Correct.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, first AMA question. Hi, Cyrus.
Wait. Your hair's standing up. What's happened there?
Okay, I just have put the headphones on weirdly, I guess.
My God, your hair's like got erections.
No, it just naturally seems to stand like that.
Why does his hair stand up? How can it stand up?
Gel?
It's horny.
Was your hair in the army? It's like saluting.
Yeah, maybe.
It's amazing. Have you ever seen hair like this?
It's actually like an in thing, right?
Yeah.
How do you do it, bud? How do you get it to be like that? Gel?
So I just cut it slightly short.
Yeah.
And then you talk to it.
Correct. I snake charm it to stand up.
Come on, what's going on?
So I cut it a little short where by default it's a little standing. And then I use some hair product.
You liar. He's using some hair product.
Obviously.
No, but not the hard kind. That's what she said.
That's not the kind of show we want to be on.
I was just going to say, Cyrus, I don't want to, but can you touch it and see?
Yeah, go ahead.
Please.
Okay, now, 1 second. Can you touch it and see? You mean touch his and see? Please, because this is audio medium.
This is
people
audio.
Are thinking, I don't get in trouble later.
Yeah, yeah.
Sweetie, come here.
So true, so true.
Lovely.
Mm. Yeah. There we go.
Like a pet chihuahua or a squirrel or something. Something sweet. All right, let's start.
Okay. First question. Hi, Freishia.
Saisha.
Freishia and Cyrus together. Sorry.
But you know Saisha because it's a pretty popular name as well.
Yeah, yeah. I know Shaisa. Yeah, okay.
Not Saish. Oh, forget it.
Okay.
Go on.
Hi, Cyrus and Freishia. I have two questions. In one of your recent episodes, you said participating in Jhalak Diklaja was not a pleasant experience. But I came across a YouTube video where you called yourself Mithun of Malabar Hill in the show.
Oh, my.
Anyway, what
labels
is your take?
Are just that.
What is your take on reality TV shows in general?
No, yes. I didn't say it was a fun experience. I said it was fun, but it's ridiculous practicing.
Right.
Have you ever done a music, dancing thing?
No, I'm not so popular.
Ha, ha, ha. 2 million. listen to me. When you rehearse, okay, they take one line at a time.
Yeah.
So what you see by the end of the dance, it's really boring. Okay, because you're doing the first line. So you're doing signal, pyar ka signal, cut. Again, signal, pyar ka signal, and that's just one movement to that.
Oh.
Then the second line, then join into the first line. So dance rehearsals and all was really, and I have a bit of a, you may not know, attention deficit, you know, I don't really sit still for long.
But then how did you become the Mithun of Malabar Hill if you didn't like it?
That's in my mind.
That's
it's like a guy
true.
Telling you how rich he is or how well he played in, you know how many guys tell me I used to play under 19 for my state and all that? All rubbish. Men just lie. I know men who in the toilet tell me I've got a very large, you know, but it's all lies.
But that's like me in singing. In my head, I think I'm great.
We have to hear you.
No.
Let the audience
also
judge.
The second problem is I don't know the lyrics to a single song.
Like Kunal.
So in my head, I'm like going for it, right? And I'm like, yeah, I'm like doing this whole
but
thing.
But you know the pretend thing like Kunal, where you mouth some fake word?
Obviously, that's how you're going for it. Nah. So you're singing the whole song.
Especially when they go for Jethro Tull concert, front row playing air guitar, which he can't play or anything. Oh, I love that fakeness. But if you sing and his hair goes down, we know that you're not a good singer.
That's true.
Come on, let's try.
No, I'm not saying that.
It'll stand up more straight, so sorry. I don't know why I'm saying that.
That's true.
Get your lawyer. Get a lawyer soon. The 10 years you'll spend in Tihar because this one stupid remark is not worth the hair on your fucking head. Oh, mate. Where's Brett Lee when we need him?
Moving on.
Okay, second question. As you guys also talk a lot of politics on the show, if you had a chance to meet any political leader, current or past, from any country and ask them one and only one question, what would that be?
Winston Churchill. How much can you put away in one night? I mean, that man could drink.
I would
just sit there and count the glasses.
Yeah.
I'd be like, okay, Vince, one more? Yeah, it'd be great to see. Who would you want to meet? It's not a question
quick,
you thought about.
Yeah.
She wants Adidas to sponsor her question.
And Sai just had such a quick answer to that one. No, that was great.
But there's
actually.
So many things you want to ask people. I always want to know personal things.
Right.
Isn't that the thing you want to ask? Oh, why did you declare war?
No.
I mean, you ask Hitler, why do you have that mustache? It's stupid.
I saw Jojo Rabbit yesterday.
Oh, God. No more tragic. Listen, I live in a make-believe world where everybody's happy. Okay? I'm like, I don't know. I'm between Yash Chopra and Karan Johar. They are my parents. You know?
Right.
I just want to dance.
That's why you went to Switzerland.
Something like that. To Mount Titilis.
Pishab
karna mana hai. Devanagari. I told you the story. No?
Yeah,
everything else is in German, French and English.
Yeah.
For Devanagari, there's only one line. Because their instructions are very clear about where to put the bag and where to go. In German, French, Italian and all. But for us, it's pishab karna mana hai. There's no other instruction. Because for us, it's very clear. The issue is only one and one thing. Please, don't urinate on our mountain, you fuckers.
Because I was also amazed, other than that Kajol and Shahrukh thing, there was one cafe downstairs.
Which serves dosas,
samosas and masala chai.
Yeah. Because that's the market, what do you want to do?
Crazy.
Yeah. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Hello, everybody. We have a brand new daily podcast we're working on with Bloomberg Quint. All You Need to Know provides the top news on business, markets, and the economy so that you can stay ahead of the curve. Tune in every morning on BloombergQuint.com, the IVM podcast app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.
Manasana Golgappya Sarkhi Astat. हाय हॅलो करताना वेगळी आणि बोलताना वेगळी आणि गप्पा मारताना वेगळी, मित्र झाली की वेगळी आणि शत्रू म्हणून वेगळी, थोडक्यात दिसणारी वेगळी आणि असणारी वेगळी, कधी आंबट कधी गोड कधी तिखट तर कधी चमचमीत आणि कधी कधी हॉट अँड स्पायसी सुद्धा. आणि म्हणूनच गप्पा, सॉरी गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर फक्त तुमच्यासाठी दर बुधवारी आयव्हीएम पॉडकास्टच्या ऍपवर, वेबसाईटवर किंवा युट्यूब चॅनलवर सुद्धा ऐकू शकता. तुम्ही आमचा पॉडकास्ट वेगवेगळ्या पॉडकास्ट प्लॅटफॉर्म वरती ऐकू शकता. फक्त सर्च करा गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर आणि आमचा पॉडकास्ट ऐकत राहा.